Is Disneyland haunted? Let's find out right now on What the Fetch. Hey weirdos, I'm Grant. If you know anything about me, then you know my family and I are huge Disney lovers. I would say that more than half of my t-shirts are of Disney-related properties. Hey, you love your stuff, and I'll love mine, okay? It's always the best when you learn that your favorite places may also be haunted. Built under the direct supervision of Walt himself, Disneyland opened to the public on July 17, 1955. We love this park, and we aren't alone. As of December 2017, the park has had over 708 million visitors since it opened. 708 million visitors. Well, 708 million living visitors. But what about the dead? Do they visit Disneyland too? I know I would. Now, I haven't ever seen a ghost at Disneyland myself, other than those, 999 happy haunts in Haunted Mansion, but there are many rumors of ghosts around Disneyland. What could be better than having a paranormal experience in the happiest place on Earth? Okay, as soon as you enter the park, you'll notice a light on in the center window above the fire station. This is Walt's personal apartment that he had built to make it easier for him to visit and to work on the park. Now, that light stays on at all times as a tribute to Walt Disney, but it wasn't always left on. You see, Walt used to turn that light on when he was visiting the park to let everyone know he was there. Well, as the story goes, soon after Walt died in 1966, a cleaning woman cleaning the apartment noticed that that particular light was left on. So she naturally turned it off. As she was leaving, she looked back and saw that that light she had just turned off was back on. Of course, she headed back in and proceeded to turn it off. Upon exiting, she noticed once again that that light was back on. Ever diligent, she popped back in to turn it off a third time, only to have it turn back on right in front of her. Supposedly, she then heard someone say, "I am still here." Since that day, no one has turned the light off. It's always left on in tribute to Walt Disney. To this day, cast members report hearing footsteps and knocking coming from the apartment, especially at night. Is this Walt? Is it anything? We don't know for sure, but the idea of Walt returning to visit his pride and joy makes perfect sense to me. Now, proceeding into the park, you may run into the lady in white wandering Main Street in a turn of the 20th century white dress, not to be confused with Mary Poppins. Legend says that she guides lost children to the Disneyland Baby Care Center to be reunited with their parents, probably undoing the work of Peter Pan. Supposedly, she died in the early 1900s on that property well before Disneyland was built, but I wasn't able to find any evidence of that. Continuing up Main Street, we come to the centerpiece of the park, Sleeping Beauty Castle. Well, a bit underwhelming, it's the original, and we love it. There aren't really any reports that I could find about the castle itself being haunted, but during one of Disneyland's many fireworks shows, someone caught a figure on the roof enjoying the show. Is this a shadowy Walt taking in the sights? Or is it a maintenance worker in uniform, very much alive, viewing the show while working? Who knows? But if I were haunting the park, you can bet your butt that's where I would be at least once. So let's head to where we know there are ghosts. Happy ghosts. 999 happy haunts, in fact. The Haunted Mansion, one of my absolute favorite rides ever. The Disneyland Haunted Mansion was built in the style of a southern antebellum manor. It was originally designed to be a rundown, disheveled building, but Walt felt that would look very odd amongst all the beautiful buildings in New Orleans Square. So Walt notoriously said, "We'll take care of the outside and let the ghosts take care of the inside." And once you go inside, the ghosts have certainly taken over. But is there more than Disney intended haunting this ride? As you board, look for Doom Buggy number 55. Supposedly, this buggy was retired for a while due to an abundance of claims of chills and someone knocking on the side of the buggy. Well, as the story goes, there was a woman who requested to scatter her child's ashes on the ride, but Disney refused, as it's their policy to always refuse requests to scatter ashes. Not to be stopped, this determined mother decided to do it anyway. Supposedly, this was done in Doom Buggy number 55. And now the buggy is back in service. Now, the ride is fun once you've ridden it hundreds of times like I have, but for a person's first ride through, it could be chill-inducing. especially if it's been particularly hot outside and now you find yourself in a nice air-conditioned dune buggy. And I've found that it's very easy to reach out and knock on another dune buggy, although I don't recommend it. Keep your hands and arms inside the ride at all times. Yeah, we know. Sorry. Now, the child whose ashes were scattered is reportedly seen near the exit of the ride, crying. Well, apparently this kid is also a fan of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride, as a small boy is seen crying by that ride too. Now, trust me, I've seen a lot of kids crying in Disneyland, but that's usually due to too much sugar and exhaustion, not to scattered ashes. But there could be some truth to this. In November 2007, LA Times reporter Kimi Yoshino reported Pirates of the Caribbean was shut down when a guest scattered a powdery substance in the water. Why is this a thing? Guys, Disneyland always refuses requests to scatter ashes for a reason. Don't go rogue and throw your loved one's remains where they're just going to end up inside someone's Poltergust 3000. Now, before we leave New Orleans Square, take a minute and visit the Columbia, over across the water from Pirates and the Haunted Mansion. Here, folks have reported seeing the figure of Walt Disney himself walking below decks, enjoying the ship. Speaking of Walt walking around, check out this video of the security cameras. You can clearly see a hint of someone walking out of Haunted Mansion, cross New Orleans Square in the second camera, only to be picked up in the third camera, continuing its journey across New Orleans Square. Unfortunately, this isn't the ghost of Walt walking the grounds. It's an artifact caused by a worn-out recording head on an analog system. These older systems record to magnetic tape. New video gets recorded over the old video, and as the recording heads wear down, they don't do as good a job of fully replacing the old video. Things in motion tend to bleed through. What we are watching is the new footage of an empty park that was recorded over a previous night's recording of a maintenance worker making his rounds. Only on the previous night, the gates to Haunted Mansion were open, so he was able to walk right through. And this particular camera here was at a different angle, making it look like the ghost is now walking across the water. True Disney magic. Let's head over to the creepiest ride, in my opinion. That's right, It's a Small World. While it's fun to pick out the hidden Disney characters on this ride, those dolls, and that song. That song is played an average of 1,200 times each day. And with the opening of It's a Small World in Disneyland Paris, that song is always playing somewhere on the planet. But the best part about this ride was that one clown that seemed to mirror our innermost feelings. This guy, the frowning clown, stuck in a balloon, quietly pleading for us to rescue him from that ride. I love it. Weird, right? What's weirder is that they have since removed the sign and painted a smile on him. Poor clown. Don't worry. We know what you're really thinking. Besides the psychotropic side of the ride, cast members report lights turning off and on by themselves, and the doll still moving after the power has been shut off for the night. Now that's creepy right there. I'm not a fan of self-moving dolls, alright? But I asked an Imagineer if there was any way the old animatronics could still move after they were powered down. And that Imagineer said that with the older pneumatic systems, there could be a slow leak in them that would make the figure just sort of slump. Or that nighttime is maintenance time. Maintenance workers could be turning on the figures to test certain things unbeknownst to the cast member making their rounds. Sadly, the ride was temporarily closed while we were there to de-Christmasify it. Perfect timing. Either way, creepy. Moving right along. It's hard to ignore the looming presence of the Matterhorn in the park. While this somewhat jarring ride can be a great chiropractor, or your chiropractor's worst enemy, we love it because, well, it has a few secrets. Hidden inside the top third of the ride is a small basketball court. Odd, right? And guys, it's got a Yeti. A Yeti. Come on, Josh Gates, get on it. But most importantly, it supposedly has a ghost. At night, two cast members are required to walk the two separate tracks to check for lost items, etc. There's one part of the track called Dolly's Dip, where they report feeling watched and hearing a woman's voice, and that the work lights always burn out. Now, in 1984, there was a 48-year-old woman named Dolly Regina Young who unfortunately passed away at this particular point in the ride, hence the name Dolly's Dip. Officials found that the seatbelt wasn't fastened at the time of the incident. Hopefully, the reports from the cast members are just overactive imaginations or residual activity, and Dolly has since moved on and only returns to the park to revisit her happy memories here. Okay, quick donut break. And back to it. Some of my happiest memories of the park were actually from the future. Tomorrowland, to be exact. As a kid, I would dream of space. I draw crazy space stations and spaceships all the time. But I would never have dreamed that my love of the future and space would collide with my love of the supernatural. Here at Space Mountain, people report seeing Mr. One Way, a red-headed, red-faced man who hops in the empty seat next to a single rider only to disappear before the end of the ride. There's also talk of a kid in line wearing 70s attire that has no knowledge of the changes made to the park after the 70s. And then there is Disco Debbie, a glowing green ghost reportedly seen on the ride. Now, starting in 2009, Space Mountain has occasionally been themed for Halloween as Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy, but none of those spooky effects featured a glowing green ghost. Disco Debbie is rumored to be the ghost of a cast member that unfortunately died of an aneurysm, although I haven't been able to find any proof of that. But unfortunately, there was a Debbie that passed away in Tomorrowland, specifically this building here. This was the original home of the Carousel of Progress. In the early 70s, that ride was moved to Disney World in Florida. It reopened the summer of 1974 as America Sings. 2 weeks after that ride opened, Deborah Stone, an 18-year-old operator, tragically passed away while near the rotating stage part of the ride. Sad indeed. But what is beautiful about this story is that cast members working the ride have reportedly heard a voice telling them to be careful. How about that? Even in the afterlife, it's possible Deborah is still being sweet and helpful. Good on you, Deborah. But she can retire now, as the building no longer has the rotating stage. It is now the home of Star Wars Launch Bay. But other entities are reported to still frequent this space. The ghosts of kids who passed away while trying to jump cars on the People Mover reportedly are seen in the high-speed tunnel section of that ride that runs through the building. And even the iconic monorail isn't without its ghosts. People report seeing the ghostly image of a teenager running along monorail tracks only to disappear as the monorail gets close. Now, this corresponds with the story of 19-year-old Thomas Guy Cleveland, who was sneaking into the park. After climbing over a fence and crossing the monorail track, he was spotted by a guard who told him how dangerous that place was. Instead of heeding the guard's warning, Thomas ran and was unfortunately struck by the monorail. Tragic. Now, keep in mind, I love Disneyland, like, a lot. And while there was tragedy in the park's history, people are people and will do what they want. Everyone I mentioned here who passed away in the park and are rumored to haunt it were consciously being negligent and blatantly ignoring the safety rules of the park. I feel extremely safe there. Disney does an excellent job of providing a clean, safe, and honestly, magical experience. I mean, it's so good that many people are possibly still visiting the park after they've passed on, regardless of how they've passed on. And remember, guys, there doesn't have to be death and tragedy for an entity to frequent a place. We're only chained to a location by our own desires. And my desire is to spend as much time at Disney as possible. So, if you want to contact me when I pass on, bring your mouse ears and K2 meters to any one of the Disney parks and you'll probably find me there. And you'll have a lot of fun too. You're welcome. Well, thanks Walt and everyone at Disney who continues to create pure magic, both intentional and paranormal. Thanks for stopping by, guys. Stay weird.